Hello friends, this video will give you a walkthrough of an application you are going to develop under the JSP Servlet course. This is a simple shopping cart application. Currently we are logged in as an anonymous user, so we can navigate through different products cart status and we can add different products into a cart. Say I add two products, but as we are not logged in, this application won't allow us to check out or place an order. So if I click on checkout, it will ask me for the user details. Let's register a new user, demo user. I'll say user demo. Email ID will be demo@gmail.com. Mobile number is not compulsory, address is not compulsory. Here your email ID will be by default treated it as a its username. Right now I don't want my email ID as my username, so I will set it as a demo. I will set the username as demo, password as demo, and I will register this user. So I've registered. Now let's log in with this demo user. Okay, great. I'm able to successfully log into my application with new user. Now you can see one more option is enabled, that is my order. So when I go to my cart, this option will tells you that what are the orders I have placed. Currently I have not placed any order, so this is blank. Let's go to the cart. It shows me all my previously selected items. So I'll check it out. I'll place the order. Yes, my order has been placed successfully. My order ID is 5. So now if I go to my orders and check, yes, I can see all the orders I have placed. Currently I have placed only one order, so there's only one order. Here it shows the status of my order. I can edit it or I can delete this order. Now let's go with the admin user. Basically there is a default user created by our application with admin rights. So its default username is admin and password is admin. So I'll log in with this admin user. Now you can see there's a admin menu is enabled, under which he can see all the list of users and admins, users and orders. So let's go to the users page. This page shows you all the list of users registered with this application. So you can see it also showing the demo user which we have registered, the second username and its email ID. There is one more user, that is one user. If I go to orders section, you can see all the orders placed by different users. So if you can see, by user 1 I have placed many orders, and recent with demo user we have placed one order. So I can see that order as well along with status. Here if you go to the product section, now you can see all the list of products along with few options are enabled, that is add product and edit. So this option should be enabled with admin. So when you log in as an admin, these options are enabled. Okay, now coming to the security part. So let's consider users is a most critical module. So user data should not be visible apart from the admin or apart from the admin. So let's say I log out from the admin. Now I'm not logged in with any user, and I copied the URL and I'll paste that URL directly into a browser. So it's not allowing me, it's not showing me the user's page, it's redirecting me to the login page. That means it's secured. So basically this course will help you to understand and use implementation technique in a sorry implementation practices followed in a real world or an industry. Also different aspect of the security covered under this application. So thank you.